We are in Jones Hole, Utah, and we're talking about the Weber Sandstone. This is a 300 million year old sandstone that probably one of the most dramatic, amazing sandstone units. And it's dramatic in terms of the way it erodes into these big canyons that form probably the most spectacular canyons in Utah is the Weber Sandstone. It's Permian, Pennsylvanian in age. And we got the entire series here. So if we spin around, look above this outcrop, you can see that at the base of this hill behind me, we have a limestone unit. So these are limestones. I'm standing on the limestone unit here. And as I walked across here to get up here, I found a nice piece of some fossils, some Pennsylvanian fossils out of the Morgan Formation, which is that limestone, and it's just full of all these rugosa corals. So coral, kind of coral reef, Paleozoic coral reef on there. And then as you go up, the ocean retreated and we get into more terrestrial environments. So more fluvial, and as we move up, the ocean retreat even further and we get these aeolian, these sand dunes at the very top that form those wonderful cross bedding, those broad trough cross beds up at the top. And if we spin around, we can see that there's this wonderful dramatic exposure of the sandstone. So it's a quartz arenite sandstone, fairly uniform in terms of its mineralogy of quartz, which indicates that it was a very dry environment in here. Now, the Weber Sandstone is pretty much across northeastern Utah. As you head south, you end up into the Uncompahgre uplift. And down there, it changes into what's called the maroon. The maroon goes into Colorado, more of a Colorado rock layer, but they're coeval. Now, the maroon is more fluvial type deposits during the Pennsylvanian and Permian, and they're on the flanks of what was called the Ancestral Rockies. So as the Ancestral Rockies, this very low mountain range that started to come up in Colorado about 300 million years ago, you form these valleys. And in this valley, we basically get these aeolian type deposits. And they've done studies on the zircon crystals in here in the Providence of where these sands were coming from in the Weber. And they were coming from Colorado. They were coming from the south and being blown out, and the ocean was retreating to the west and to the north. And so we are left with this wonderful sequence going from marine rivers up into sand dunes, very dry valley that formed here. In some places, on the very top, we get the ocean comes back through, and in some places you can get some evaporitic deposits as this ocean retreated during this period of time while we're on the shore. Now, the Permian in Pennsylvania is a really interesting period of time in terms of climate here in Utah. Here in Utah, we are near the equator, and we are also on the edge, the very western edge of the North American continent, which was squished in to all the other continents in the world to form Pangaea. So Pangaea was this supercontinent that formed here, and this is all happening on the edge, on the western shore of the west coast of Pangaea. So we have very dramatic climatic shifts, and so we can see some of that in the rocks that we're going to look at. So we're down here in Jones Hole, and when you're in Jones Hole, you got to go fishing. So we're hiking along Jones Hole Creek, probably one of the most beautiful places in Utah. Great fishing spot, but also a great place to look at some of these late Paleozoic rocks. So this is the Morgan Formation that we're encountering. These are the limestones. They're down in here. And we're gonna be looking at some of these rocks that are much higher up stratigraphically, which are the Weber Sandstone. But these are all marine limestones that are here. So for a limestone to form, it needs to be a pretty shallow marine system. So it needs to be a shallow ocean that existed here during the Pennsylvanian period. And it's formed out of the photosynthesizing organisms. But there's a lot of chert and stuff in this. Probably should have done this hike for the Morgan layer rather than the Weber. But if you look behind me, and we swivel around and look up into the, up above, we can see the beautiful Weber sandstone that forms these wonderful canyons down in here along the rivers.
We're going to have to pretend we're walking down the road for the first time.
So occasionally the Weber sandstone falls down, so you need to watch out for falling giant rocks out of the sky in these canyons. So as pertains to these rock falls off of the Weber sandstone. So let's keep hiking. So this is really cool. This rock right here, this giant rock right here, it's huge. I mean, this is a big rock, but it came down from way up there. So this is a piece of the Weber sandstone. Fell off this really high cliff way up there. Came crashing down. Just, I think this happened in 2013. And here we have this big, huge sandstone right here. There's another one right there in the river. Here's another big, huge, giant rock. You can see it came crashing down and hit this tree right here. This is pretty incredible. You can see there's some more rocks over there that have come down, falling into the river. And we are right below that big landslide that happened. So you can see where all these rocks just came off. Pretty massive boulders. Look at how it made a path through here, where it broke down. Oh, look at this tree. This tree got totally smashed and this boulder came down. Oh my goodness. Look at that. See, coming down. Oh my goodness. Look at the path of this boulder blasting through here. Holy moly. That is incredible. You can see this giant boulder. Look at how big it is. Fleece, be scale.
I can't.
Just be the size you are. And look at how giant this boulder was that smashed through here. That is incredible. Wow, look at this tree. Felice, look at this tree. It's just like totally squished.
I can't see it.
See the tree?
Oh, poor tree.
It just totally smashed, isn't it? That's incredible.
Can we go before we die?
So the Weber sandstone is known for having these wonderful pictographs. You see some other ones up there? These are really cool petroglyphs, just beautiful. I love the petroglyphs in this canyon. They've been painted onto the Weber sandstone. They're just wonderful. There's a little dog in that one, I think. It looks like a dog. Those look like some of the bighorn sheep that live in this canyon. Now, one of the things that's always kind of fascinated me about the Weber sandstone are some of the weird features that you see in it. So here we have the petroglyphs right here behind me that are about 1,000 years old. Fremont, three figures here, and some other symbols, probably sort of a basket or something there, and waves. And then if you look above, right above the petroglyphs, you'll see these weird soft deformation markings, which is these weird structures, these squiggly structures that you see in the Weber sandstone. Now, I've puzzled over these things because they're really quite fascinating to take a look at. They're basically where the sand bedding has been jumbled up for some way, some fraction. Now, we might have a clue. If we look above that, we see a mudstone, kind of a limey mudstone. So we have like a wet unit on top of this Aeolian unit, which may have indicated that this water up here, the sand, became saturated with water. And then with movement during that saturation time, that zone there, it caused this soft deformation of the sand, so it's not bedded like the normal sand underneath, which is really interesting and pretty fascinating. So here we have some wonderful, interesting deformation features in this Weber sandstone right above the petroglyphs that we see here. So pretty beautiful petroglyphs here. So really cool. Just amazing to think that these are painted 1,000 years ago, people living in this canyon. Great place to live, you know. Fresh source of water, and you had fishing, and you had bighorn sheep that range up through these canyons, and you're protected. There's a lot of rock shelters too, where you can shelter from the rain and the cold during the winter. So great place to live, and beautiful. It's just beautiful here, it's amazing. Really interesting and fascinating things about the Permian and Pennsylvanian was there's a period of time in which all the continents were coming together. And Utah was positioned along the western coast of this giant supercontinent, this Pangaea. And what that meant was that this coastline was a coastline to a giant super ocean. Isn't that strange, soft deformation in that sandstone? That big limey mudstone on top of it coming across saturated the sand underneath it, and that caused it to shift, produce all sorts of weird bedding patterns, these weird sedimentary structures along there. It's pretty cool. See that a lot in the Weber sandstone. So that means it was very dry, but then you'd have periods of very wet, but long periods too, which is interesting. So there's a big fault that runs through here called the Island Park Fault, which is right kind of behind me. So we can see the Weber sandstone over here, these outcrops. And then as we pan over here, we can see that those rocks behind me are limestones. And those are Mississippian limestones, so they're older rocks. And you can see up there, there's some wonderful caves because they're limestones. Yep. One of the really incredible things about these canyons is that they form these little microclimates. And so it's really lush in here. A lot of vegetation, a lot of trees. And this is because these canyon walls kind of trap a lot of the moisture, and then you have a river running through it. So they tend to be more wet than the surrounding desert of Utah. So they're like little oases here in Utah. Little places where a lot of vegetation grows, a lot of rare and endangered plants live in these types of small canyons that run along these rivers in these canyons, and they're sort of protected from the harsh, dry environment of Utah's intense sun. So pretty fun hike down into this canyon today. Pretty spectacular geology. The Weber Sandstone, just a fantastic unit. Just a really gorgeous, gorgeous canyon that we're in. And it's just wonderful to be out here and to just really enjoy just looking at rocks, looking at geology, looking at, you know, petroglyphs, these ancient markings left on the Weber Sandstone. And although the Weber Sandstone is not known for having many fossils, has a few trace fossils, fossil footprints, it is just gorgeous in terms of the canyons that you see. And just, I know, it's just a really, really pretty unit, based on, mostly on the fact that it forms these wonderful canyons that we can hike and explore in.